What, in the final question, do you, I read your piece you just put up about Rojava, and do you have a message of solidarity for Rojava and the Kurds?
Absolutely. Because you know why? Because as I wrote there, of course, they are not angels in the sense of purity. They have their own corruption, struggles, and so on. But I follow the situation very closely there. What shocked me is that whenever they were given a little bit of a breathing space, they did incredible things. People attacked me because in that article that you were kind enough to mention, I talk also about the Kurdish feminism. They say, ha ha, are you kidding? No, I'm not. Do you remember it was even in our media when Kurds from Rojava region were fighting ISIS? The key role was played by feminine soldiers and so on. It's unique in the Middle East and so on. Even, I know the situation in detail, the imprisoned Öcalan, leader of Turkish Kurds, you know that in prison he turned a feminist now. He proposes this sexual openness to other sex practices, women's well, and so on and so on. They're an absolutely incredible phenomenon. The only like glimmer of hope in that area where all other stations around are again just drowning in their patriotic, national, totally corrupted sovereignty, like let's call them Turkey, Iraq, Syria. They are the only glimmer of hope, and of course, they will probably be destroyed.
It's and forgive me, I just want to add, there's another echo of it, and that is actually the Kurdish HDP political party in Turkey, who broadened out a social democratic base, ecological, feminist, and labor.
They performed
well, now they're political prisoners in Erdogan's Turkey, and it echoes exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, but isn't this a nice paradox? Because as I said in the text of mine, we perceive automatically, because we were fed by these stories, Kurds had some primitive tribal part. No, they are the most secular modern part of Turkish society. It's incredible, I mean.
Slava Zizek, thank you so much. I hope you'll do this again with us, maybe even in studio.
And I hope I will do it face to face, not through this stupid media and so on. I would love to visit you. I like Brooklyn. You know why? Because in some part of Brooklyn, you have now, where there are all those new skyscrapers and so on, they opened there another Katz restaurant. And you get the best matzo ball soup there. I don't like Jewish food in Israel. It's the same cheap as the Arab food, hummus, all that bullshit. I like Eastern European Jewish food, matzo ball and so
you
on.
You like the real thing. You like the knishes. You like the real shit.
Yeah. Yep. And you can get it better one than on Manhattan. You get it in Brooklyn. So I'm with you.
Okay, brother. Well, I'll see you soon.
If we do a talk there, I invite you to matzo ball.
Beautiful. Let's do it. I'm going to hold you to it. Slavo,
okay, thanks very much.
I hope you enjoyed this. This was so much fun.
I did. It's a breath of fresh air again. I'm ill, in a bad mood, and I was able to forget for 45 minutes the misery of my existence here now.
That's the highest of compliments. You just watched a Michael Brooks Show video. Subscribe to get them all. Why wouldn't you? Don't be foolish. Click subscribe below and become a patron as well. Patreon.com/TMBS. Thanks, everybody.